Come on, Chet, let's go.
Give me a minute, boo.
Come on, the first period's almost over.
It's a score.
Nothing.
Who's winning?
The Eagles, you fool.
Damn, you touchy tonight. Can't even take a shit.
Well, that's because I thought we were going to the game tonight. Because account of your dumb, slow ass, we're not going to get there till the end of the first period.
Better late than never.
Come on, let's go, asshole.
You made it chill out, right? Well, sit, calm down, watch the first period here, and we'll go to the bar, right?
Fine. What are you talking about?
Look, if we get there during the period, the bar's going to be jam-packed, right? But if we get there during the intermission, people are going to be outside getting fresh air, macking the hose, taking a leak, and the bar will be nice and accessible, and we can get our beers, sit down, watch the game, right?
You know, I'd hate even more if you didn't throw in those little nuggets of logic every once in a while.
And you keep underestimating me.
And back for the beak. The play of this game. Somewhere in all that.
Hey. Hey, how are you? Oh, yeah? I know where you at. Alright. You see this light coming up? Make a right. Then hang a right on Dirt Street. Immediately make a left, alright? You're the seventh house on the right. You got it. Late. Which what?
Who is that? It sounded like you were giving directions to our house. Were you expecting someone or something?
Well, I was gonna tell you later, but I guess the cat's out of the bag now.
So it'll be a good one.
For the last 5 years, you've been dating that Caitlin bitch. It's so uptight, she wouldn't even, you had to steal second base on. She barely even let your friends kiss her, right?
Only when she let me.
And there you go. That's just what I'm talking about. Caitlin's such a heinous bitch, she doesn't pick just any old day to break up with you. She picks your motherfucking birthday. You're supposed to go out to a fancy restaurant. Shit.
Thanks for bringing it all back to me.
But you've been doing a lot better, right?
Yeah, and I'll be doing even better when we go to Hammerhead's intermission.
Okay, now I know I'm your best friend, right? So naturally, I want to make you feel it. So that's why tonight, in this very crib, I've got one of the finest women in Philly coming over for your adult pleasure, courtesy of Joe the Big Kahuna.
Hold on. All the girls that Joe know, they're all sluts.
Exactly.
No, fucking no.
I'm gonna get you laid tonight, brother!
No. This is exactly why I don't want to go to Joe's party. This is not my plan of getting over Caitlin.
The hell's your problem? A little cheap action is all you need to release all that pent-up sexual frustration you've been carrying around 5 years because that bitch Caitlin was such a prude.
And how could you do this without asking me? You know I hate being set up.
Shit, I'm trying to help you out and this is the thanks I get.
Listen here, you're a dirty little...
Ah, the entertainment has arrived.
Chet, wait.
Wait, what?
For the love of God, have you lost your fucking mind?
Man, I'm your best friend. I've known you since the sandbox. I'm just looking out for your ass. Come on.
When I'm ready to replace Caitlin, I will. I'll do it on my own. I don't need your help.
You don't need another girl. Caitlin was another girl. What you need is a woman. I got a fine woman waiting on the outside of that door.
Chet. Will you please stop trying to set me up? I mean, if you're going to set me up, will you please set me up with a nice woman?
I've known nice girls. There ain't nothing with them.
Yeah, you're the Mr. Sensitivity poster child, right? You let them pour their hearts out, then you jump their bones.
I don't go for the nice girls, Mother. I go for the wild ones. The wild ones are the combatants of the games I play. What you need is a wild girl, and Joe's going to come through tonight.
Listen here, you little punk.
Welcome, my dear. Come on in. Mike, I want you to meet Joe's good friend, Nicole. She's from London. You can have a seat over there. Look, you can stay here or you can go to Hammerhead's. Truthfully, I don't give a shit what you do. Just tell me.
I'll stay.
Beautiful. Your lady awaits. Damn. So I says to the guy, I says, this place ain't fit for Fred Sanford to live in, fool. So he's looking at me, he says, so what? So I says, what? And he kind of looks at me, he's like, you fucking jerk off. And it was ridiculous. Now that's a funny story, right, Mikey?
Yeah, real funny. Like Joe Pesci and Goodfellas.
Shit, man, you like Bernie Mac. You should take that act on the road.
Bite me.
Well, peeps, I think I'm gonna head out. Go down to Hammerheads, find some women, drink some booze. You two have a good time. I'll talk to you later. Peace out!
Well, that Flyers team's probably in the second period. You wanna go watch?
Definitely.
So, you like hockey?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, to me it's only a real sport. Oh, look at that save by Boucher!
Oh.
I really hope the Flyers win. We could really use a win in this series.
True.
Ah, shit! You don't have your drink. Shall I get it for you?
Sure.
Great. I was just getting you a drink for you.
Put the glass down.
Why? What's up? What do you want?
You! Don't you want this?
Want what?
Me!
I don't know. My mind's all fucked up right now.
Don't you want this?
I do, believe me. If it was any other time.
What? Is it me then?
No, it's not that.
Hold on. Joe told me that...
fuck what Joe said. It's probably a lie anyway. Joe don't even know me. We met once at a party for 5 minutes.
Look, it's not like I'm trying to take advantage of you. I just thought this is what you wanted. I mean, I wouldn't be here if you didn't want something.
Look, I don't know anything. Chet put this whole thing together without even asking me. Look, you're a beautiful woman. If this was any other time, I would definitely make a run at you, but it's just right now.
Hey, come on. Don't worry about it. Look, I'm not going to make you do anything you don't want to, all right?
Thanks.
Maybe it would help you if you talked about it. What's the problem?
Caitlin Washington.
Who?
My ex-girlfriend.
How long were you two dating?
5 years.
My God, that's a really long time to be with somebody and then break up.
Yeah, even longer when you gotta live through it and then deal with the repercussions.
What happened, eh?
Me and Caitlin were together for 5 years. We met at a pool hall one night. She was taking Chet's ass in 8-ball when she saw me. She came over, challenged me to a game. Of course she won, and won $20. But later that night she took me to Denny's and bought me a midnight snack.
You don't have to tell me if you don't want to.
No, it's okay. I mean, basically we started a relationship that night, and the first 3 years were the best time of my life.
And then it was all downhill, right?
Yeah, and then somewhere around, you know, the end of the third, beginning of the fourth, it just went terrible. She started acting real weird. Went real deep into her work and her so-called work colleagues. It was terrible at that point.
And did you tell her how you felt about all that?
Yeah, I told her, but I stayed together for so long because I thought she'd change, but she never did.
How long ago did you two break up?
Yesterday. Last night on my fucking birthday.
My God, that's such a sad story.
Don't I know it.
Listen, I gotta use the loo. But you're not gonna go anywhere, are you?
No, I'll be right here.
Great, because I want to keep talking.
Oh, man.
Hi, Caitlin. It's Mike.
Who?
Mike. Mike Collins, your ex-boyfriend.
Oh, yeah. My ex-boyfriend.
Right. How drunk are you?
Drunk? You kidding me? I never drink. Oh, man.
Oh. Yeah, sure. Whatever. Listen, Caitlin, I have something to tell you.
Oh, yeah, what is it?
Look, Caitlin, I still love you and I want you in my life. Look, I'll do anything. I'll do anything. You tell me exactly what you want me to do to change and I'll do it. I'll do anything. But please, just give me another chance. You know what, Caitlin? I don't love you. I thought I had feelings for you, but you know what? I don't. I'm moving on.
Are you kidding me, Rico? That's the worst impression of Mike I've ever heard. Get new impressions, man. Oh, man.
Goodbye, Caitlin.
It's a loser.
How's your night going with that British bitch?
Pretty good, actually.
Oh, yeah? So did you take it to that bitch or what?
Nah, man, we just talked all night. You know, she's a real nice girl. I just drove her home. We watched Friars game, that's it.
Oh, shit, I'm sorry, boy. I thought you would give me some ass, man. I'm going to talk to Joe and tell him you guys send me some good bitches next time.
Nah, man, it wasn't anything like that. She was real nice company. I didn't want it.
Shit, as long as you had a good time, I'm happy for you, boy, but guess what? I need some sleep. Nigga gotta sleep this load off. I'll talk to you later.
Walk away if you want to. It's okay.
What's up?
Yes, how are you cats this morning?
Pretty good, pretty good.
Hey, it's gonna be a beautiful fucking day, isn't it?
Damn right.
Should I tell him, man?
Yeah, go for it.
Later on today, we're going to the aquarium. Would you care to join us?
Now, you know, I got some shit to do. You know, prior engagements that can't be made any other day, if you know what I'm saying.
Maybe next time then, Chet.
Excuse me, I gotta hit the loo. I'll
be right back. Lou, what that bitch talking about? Lou, what the fuck's a Lou?
I don't know.
So what is this?
What's what?
You and this Nicole.
What's it look like?
I think you two be hooking up.
You are right, my friend. Last night when I told you I took her home,
yeah,
she was up in my room. We talked all night long.
Damn, brother, I don't care what you want to call it. Congratulations, man.
Man, I haven't felt this good in years. Best I've felt.
And all it took was some loving from that British bitch?
That's it.
Damn, boy, what about Caitlin?
Ancient history.
Boy, I ain't never been so proud of you, fool.
Look, calm down, man. I want to take this slow. I don't want to screw this up in the cold. I want to take it nice and slow.
But there's definite possibilities, right?
Infinite possibilities.
Shit. Looks like I'll be bouncing the clubs alone from now on.
Sorry, man. I'm not gonna do that anymore. I'm leaving the clubs all to you.
Shit, man. You have to find a way to move on with that.
Hey, come on. Didn't you ever think of settling down?
Shit, boy. Maybe someday. Right now, nigga's young. He's virile. He's ready to hit the town. Bounce it while he's got it. You know what I'm saying?
You sure you don't want to come along with us then?
And I think we're gonna let you two alone today, you know what I'm saying? There'll be other times for us to chill, yo.
Definitely.
Alright, I gotta bounce. Place to see people that do. Take care of him or I'll come after you.
Don't worry. He'll be just fine.
Ah. What?
Is he always like that?
Oh, yeah. He'll never change.
Dear, alone with all your letters, you're letting it go, no, like innocence and feathers. You're putting it down, sounds slipping into songs. You're leaving me here, dear, alone with all my wrongs. You're pulling away, pray you're making the right choice.
Since you left me.